Number is getting increased. Okay. So today is our main. Yes. So today is our major is to, you know, study about units. So first of all, we will study about the definition of unit and what is a unit and why we are using it, the characteristics of a good unit. So those are the things that we need to study in the next 10 slides. Okay. So a quantity that is measurable quantity, which is known as physical quantity, right? So we have n number of examples like mass, length, time, anything that you can measure, right? So the other thing is, you know, a physical quantity, when it is measured, it is always expressed in terms of what? It is expressed magnitude, just a minute, magnitude multiplied by what? Magnitude multiplied by its unit. The magnitude multiplied by its unit. Just a minute. Give me a minute. Who's that?
Sir, can you note down this, sir?
Just a minute. I think, let me lock my screen first of all. Disable annotation of others. And you are asking, sorry, in between, you know, while concentrating on the board, just could you please ask me the same question again? Can you? Hello. Hello, who asked that question, please? Otherwise, I will move on. If there is no issues. Is there any technical issue?
Sir, we'll write this, sir.
Okay, that I will tell you how to write it. Okay. Don't have to worry. So yesterday we wrote a, you know, a unit, sorry, a heading name is unit, right? Below it, you may write it like this. A physical quantity after measurement, it is always expressed in the format magnitude multiplied by unit. That?
Yes, sir.
Okay, just a minute. A general notice to all. Due to range issue, if you are, you know, you got cut from the meeting, you are supposed to inform me. Why? Because when I am marking attendance, at the last of that particular period, you know, if he or she is not present as a participant, I may not be able to understand who left and why left. Right? Am I correct on that?
Okay, sir.
So you are supposed to inform me. I am not taking any name. If you are attending, you are supposed to inform me about that. Personally, you can put it in the Teachmeet app. Or you can personally message me. There is no issue regarding the same. There may be range issues. Okay. So I'll move on to that next slide. I hope you got me there. And tomorrow, there will be exam for JEE and NEET students for 3 hours. The time is from 9:30 to 12:30. Okay. So what we are going to, you know, deal with is that how to write or what is unit actually.
So for regular students, we don't have.
It is for JEE NEET only. So that is, you know, if we are writing the distance as 25 kilometers, actually this means that this 25 kilometers is a 25 times magnification of 1 kilometer. Or the same can be represented using the animation because the 1 kilometer is this 1 kilometer is the basic quantity that is used here, right? So that 1 kilometer 25 times will yield you what? 25 kilometers. No need of writing this. This is just to understand. Okay. Got it?
Yes, sir. Again.
Why not? Suppose you, there is, you know, suppose the distance from your home to the nearest biggest market or the largest market, if it is 25 kilometer, which means that, you know, the distance is 25 times magnification of 1 kilometer, because 1 kilometer is the standard unit, or kilometer is the standard unit that is used to measure distance between two places, right? Half a kilometer, 1 kilometer, 1.5 kilometer, right? So 25 kilometers means it is 25 times magnification of 1 kilometer. That is 25 times you have to travel 1 kilometer. So that becomes 25 kilometer. That is the meaning of this. Any doubts on this? Hello? Am I audible?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir, audible. Yes, sir.
So here the 25 represents the magnitude. Magnitude is a measure of magnification of unit. And this kilometer here will represent what? It will represent unit. So unit is a particular standard that is used to measure, or it is used to express a measured quantity. Okay. Unit is what? Unit is a standard reference which is used for a measurement of a physical quantity. You need to write only the this definition of unit. No need of writing what is magnitude. So what is unit? Unit is a standard reference which is used for the measurement of a physical quantity. Unit is a standard reference which is used to measure, or which is used to express the measurement of a physical quantity. That if it is done, just let me know.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Write, I think it is better to write this one also, the magnitude also. You may write that one also. Yes, magnitude is a measure of magnification of units. Please write that also, magnitude. Yes, dear Alan. Number of participants is 27. May I know whether Jayamitran, Jayanita, Dharun, Supreet, are they present here? Jayamitran, Jayanita, Dharun, no. Okay, Dharun is present here. Darshan is there. Jayamitran and Jayanita is not there. Okay. Done? Let's be done.
1 minute, 2 seconds.
Just to write magnitude. The magnitude is a measure of magnification of unit. Just a minute. It is not changing. Now we're allowed to stop. This is not changing. Just a minute, I will stop sharing and I will reshare the slide again. Is Pravesh? Where is Pravesh? Pravesh, hello. Am I audible? Pravesh?
Sure.
No. I was just whether you are present or not. Just was asking.
Okay, sure.
Just a minute. Discord. Okay. Screen share. Okay. And slide. So we have talked about this particular slide, and you know, this is the examination.
Sir, will you show the before slide, sir?
Right. This one.
Yes, sir, for unit we'll write.
Unit, kindly write it fast. Unit is a standard reference. Unit is a standard reference which is used for measurement of a physical quantity. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So the next is, you know, this is the examination viewpoint definition of a unit. Because the units, you know, I'll ask you one question. If you suppose, you know, one shop is here, let it be A, the shop is B. Okay, if you bought 1 kg of sugar from each of the shop, okay, so approximately or accurately, I'll tell you, not approximately, accurately, how much amount of gram of sugar will be present in each of this kg? How much amount of gram of sugar will be present in each of this kilogram? In each kilogram? Or just convert 1 kilogram. Just convert 1 kilogram into grams. Hello.
1,000 grams,
right? 1,000 grams is the. So whether you bought the sugar from shop A or shop B, it is 1,000 grams. It is uniform throughout, whether it is in Tamil Nadu, whether it is in Kerala, or whether it is in any other part of world, right? Hello. All the units today, what we use is, you know, uniform throughout the world, right? So what is a unit? A unit is a, you know, a quantity that is used to express the value of another measured quantity, but the unit is uniform throughout the world, and it is used as what? It is used as a reference because here itself, if you are looking, it is 1,000 grams can be only expressed as, or it is only equal to 1 kilogram, right? So it is a particular set of reference, and this standard is actually called as what? Unit. So it is a reference. It is an internationally accepted way of expressing the magnitude, and it must be uniform. And what it is? It is used to measure, or it is used to express a measurement. Got it? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So please write the definition of unit. This is the most important definition of unit. Measurement of any quantity involves comparison with a certain basic, arbitrarily chosen, internationally accepted reference standard. So it must be uniform throughout the world.
Sir, what is this arbitrarily, sir?
Arbitrarily means, can you give the permission? I have recorded the whole session, but you know, due to some constraint, I'm not able to upload it on my YouTube channel, or whether it is to share with you. So after editing, I will share the whole, whether it is the previous classes also, I have recorded the whole classes. Only some classes I haven't recorded. Some issues. I am recording now also. Okay. So this arbitrarily chosen means, you know, arbitrarily chosen means that you are choosing according to your sense. That is, it is not based upon any scientific facts or evidences. Sorry, it is not based upon, you know, a particular country's interest like that. It is you are choosing something that is arbitrarily chosen. Okay. Hello. My audible.
Okay, sir.
Done with the definition of unit. So yes, we know there are two kind of quantities.
Yes, sir. Come.
Okay, there are two kind of quantities: fundamental quantities and derived quantities. Right. The units of fundamental quantities are the utmost basic units, and they are called as fundamental units, about which we have written earlier. Right. While writing that table, we have written, right. So the units of fundamental quantities are called the fundamental units. And what will be the units of derived quantity? The units of derived quantity will be derived units. The units of derived quantity will be derived unit. I think the units of derived quantities are called as derived units. Okay, kindly write that 2 points also. The units of fundamental quantities are called fundamental units. The units of other physical quantity that can be expressed as a multiple of or a combination of fundamental units is called as, are called as what? Derived quantity. For example, the unit of force, mass multiplied by acceleration, that is kilogram, is the unit of mass. The unit of acceleration is meter per second square. So the unit of force is kilogram meter per second square. And this is abbreviated as what? This is abbreviated as Newton. Okay, this is abbreviated as Newton. Done. I hope it is done.
Yes, sir, completed. Yes, sir.
So the next thing, you know, we are going to talk about, you know, what are the characteristics of a unit? Or what are the characteristics of a unit? So, you know, sometimes we will not be using the convenient way to measure the same quantities. Okay. So I'll tell you one thing. In order to measure the weight of a person, or the measured weight of a person can be expressed in terms of kilogram, right? While measuring our body weight, we always express it in kilograms, right? But can we use the same unit to express the weight of a single drop of water? Is it convenient to use the same unit, you know, to express the weight of a single drop of water? Is it convenient or is it good to use it? No, right?
According
to the scientists, you know, there must be some other units that are convenient according to situation in order to express what? In order to express the measured quantity. Okay. So we are going to talk about that particular point. So here, if you have known, the length was measured with the help of hand, but all the fingers are not equal in length in our hand, right? Am I correct on that point? So, you know, there are different units that is to be used according to the situation. So if this situation is given, but what if a very short and very tall person walks? So in the earlier, this there was a unit called as league, that is the distance covered by a man walking in an hour. Okay, so if this person walks and this person walks, the distance covered will be very different, right? The distance covered will be very different, right? Hello?
Yes, sir.
So, sir. We cannot use the same unit that which used to express the distance covered by this man, and the distance covered by this man has to be expressed in different units, right? So, we cannot use a single unit to express the distance covered by both peoples. Are you clear on this point?
Yes, sir.
So we'll write it, no issues. So the units should have a certain characteristics. It is already understood from this situation. So you just look at here. So what the first person is saying, that is, we have to measures of only 100 and 200 gram. But the second person want to measure the weight of an elephant. So is it convenient to use the unit gram, or is it easy to use kilogram?
No, sir.
No,
it is easy to use kilogram, sir.
Kilogram.
It is easy to use kilogram. So, the kilogram. First characteristics that is that the unit must be suitable and it must be easily available. Kindly write by writing a heading. Characteristics of a unit. Unit must be suitable size and easily available. The next point is that a unit should be easily available and reproducible at any place required. So easily available is a point that we wrote earlier. But what about reproducible at any place required? How to explain that point? Suppose, you know, in the animation, it was clearly shown that, you know, the other person B, he wants to measure the weight of an elephant, right? So he used, it is convenient for him to use the unit kilogram. Similarly, suppose if another person C is there, if he or she wants to use the unit, you know, if he or she wants to measure the weight of, a ship, just imagine. So can we use this unit called kilogram? No, it is better to use something called as quintal or many other units. And at the same instant, if that person C, if he or she wants to measure the weight of rice, okay, placed in a bag, it is convenient to use the unit kilogram, right? Hello? So what I want you to know, is that, you know, in these cases, okay. So what I want you to understand is that in both situations, what we did, just a minute, I think we are also running out of time. So in both situations where the other person needed to measure the weight of an elephant or the weight of rice placed in a bag, he had to use the same unit kilogram, right? Hello? So easily reproducible means, this is the fact that means easily reproducible at any place required. According to the situation, it must be easily usable also. Done? Hello?
Sir, will you explain second point, sir?
Yes, why not? It must be easily reproducible at any place required. Suppose in that animation, person B wants to measure the weight in the unit kilogram, right? Suppose if you want to measure the amount of rice in a bag, will you use gram, milligram, or kilogram? Which of this unit is convenient to use?
Kilogram, sir.
Kilogram only, right? So why? Because that is the convenient way to express that particular quantity. So if you want to express in this situation also, and in the earlier situation also, it was convenient to use the unit kilogram. So according to the situation, this unit must be usable. That is what meant by this reproducible. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Any doubts after this? Anyone? Anybody, any doubts after this? Hello?
No doubts, sir.
Written.
Yes, please. Divisri, please.
Completed, sir.
Okay. Just a minute. I'll reshare. a minute, it is not moving. Give me a minute here.
So your screen.
Yes, okay. Yes, my screen, that like it is just okay. This now it is moving. Give me a minute. Start. Okay. The unit must be universally accepted. What is the meaning of this? Who will help?
Everywhere on the globe, they have to accept.
Everyone
it.
Should know that.
Yes. I think Shane.
Everyone should know that this unit is
on. Everyone
it should be applicable universally.
Yes, it should be.
Everyone should accept it worldwide. Everyone should accept it worldwide.
Everyone should accept it worldwide, or it is applicable worldwide. So if you measure, you know, a weight 1 kilogram in India, that must be equal to 1,000 gram. Whether you measure in Pakistan or in China or in any other part of the world, 1 kilogram is always worth 1 kilogram.
Yes, or is it?